حياتي مع الله أجمل مع الله تحلو الحياة.
يخبرني كثير من الناس أن كثيرا من البشر دخلوا الإسلام بسبب ابتسامة.
He says that a lot of people are unaware that so many have entered the fold of Islam because of a smile.
أريد أن أسألهم سؤال.
I want to ask you a question.
ما هي أكبر دولة إسلامية من ناحية عدد السكان؟
Which country has the largest population of Muslims?
إذا جاوبت تأخذ 1,000 pounds.
If you answer, you get 1,000 pounds.
From Sheikh Mufti, طبعا.
From oh. 1,000 pounds in terms of weight. That's about 500 kilograms. MashaAllah.
خلهم يجاوبوا.
Okay, he says, which country has the largest population?
لأن في فوضى. هذا جاوب هذا جاوب تحجب الجائزة.
He says, because there is confusion and chaos, there's no orderly response, we cancel the prize.
Raise your hand.
He says, you got to put your answer, hand up in an orderly hand. Way.
Finish. Okay. Alf mabruk.
Oh, wow, he's congratulating me.
Alf bound in your...
£1,000 in your pocket.
I wish I had £1,000 in my pocket, mashallah.
Ya ikhwani wa ya akhawati, Indonesia akbar dawla مسلمة من ناحية عدد السكان فيها أكثر من 300 مليون مسلم.
He says Indonesia is the country that has the largest Muslim population, close on to 300 million.
كيف أصبحت هذه الدولة دولة إسلامية وكيف دخلها الإسلام؟
Do you know how Islam has actually entered this country and how they became Muslim?
دخلها الإسلام عن طريق أخلاق التجار الحضارم من اليمن.
He says from what is recorded, the Yemeni traders who came there, their character and conduct, their honesty, and the way they dealt is what resulted in them entering the fold of Islam after seeing the beauty of it.
كانوا يسافرون إلى إندونيسيا من أجل التجارة ويتعاملون مع أهلها بأخلاق الإسلام.
They used to travel all the way to Yemen and they used to trade with the non-Muslims. They used to travel from Yemen all the way to Indonesia and trade with the non-Muslims there in order to do business with them.
دخلها فأعجب الأندونيسيين بأخلاقهم وبدينهم فدخلوا في دين الله أفواجا.
So the people of Indonesia saw their character, their honesty, their conduct, and they entered the fold of Islam in large numbers.
فأصبحت الآن أكبر دولة إسلامية من ناحية عدد السكان دخلها الإسلام بالأخلاق.
So today it is the largest populated Muslim country, and this was the way Islam had entered it.
وأبشركم بشارة أن الأخلاق عبادة عظيمة.
He says, I give you good news. I want to tell you that your character and conduct, the way you carry yourself, is a great, great act of worship.
فأكثر ما يدخل الجنة كما أخبر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has informed us that that quality which will result in the most number of people entering Jannah will be
تقوى الله وحسن الخلق.
The consciousness of Allah and grand or great character and conduct.
فتقوى الله بينك وبين الله.
So the consciousness of Allah, known as taqwa, also translated as piety sometimes, is between you and Allah. That relationship between you and Allah.
وحسن الخلق بينك وبين خلق الله.
And the good character and conduct is the relationship between you and the rest of the creatures of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
وأنا قلت بينك وبين خلق الله ولم أقل بينك وبين المسلمين.
He says, I said, the relationship between you and the creatures of Allah. I didn't say between you and the Muslims only.
لأن الله عز وجل أمرنا بالإحسان وبالأخلاق الحسنة مع المسلم وغير المسلم.
Allah has asked us to be kind, to be good, to show good character and conduct to the Muslims as well as to the non-Muslims.
Allah say in the Holy Quran.
يقول الله عز وجل في القرآن.
وقولوا للناس حسنا.
And speak to the people in a beautiful way.
للناس وليس للمسلمين فقط.
The people, not the Muslims alone. When you speak to people, say that which is good.
فأيضا الأخلاق تجعلك يوم القيامة من أقرب الناس منزلا من الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Your good character and conduct on the day of judgment will actually make you earn a position from amongst the closest to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم on the day of judgment.
فالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن من أقربكم مني منزلا يوم القيامة أحاسنكم أخلاقا.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, indeed, from among those who will be the closest to me on the day of judgment will be those with the best of character and conduct.
وفي الحديث أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أخبر وقال.
And in the hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم informed us by saying.
إن الرجل لا يبلغ بحسن خلقه درجة الصائم القائم.
A person would actually achieve the status through his good character and conduct of one who fasts constantly and one who prays constantly.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul fi surah al-Isra.
In surah al-Isra, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ.
And tell my worshippers to say that which is the best, to use the best words when they are talking.
وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَنْزَغُ بَيْنَهُمْ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ كَانَ لِلْإِنسَانِ عَدُوًّا مُبِينًا.
And tell my worshippers to use the best possible words when they are speaking, to say that which is the best. For indeed, the devil creates enmity and hatred between them, or misunderstandings between them. For indeed, the devil or shaitan is an outright, open, clear enemy against man.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qad zakka nabiyahu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi sadrihi faqal.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has purified the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by saying,
أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ.
Have we not purified for you or cleansed for you your chest?
والله سبحانه وتعالى زكاه في لسانه فقال.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has purified him upon his tongue, and Allah has said,
وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ.
Indeed, the messenger does not utter from his own whims and fancies, but everything he says is actually revelation inspired by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allah azza wa jal zakkahu fi tadayyunihi wa fi hidayatihi.
Ma dhalla sahibukum wa ma ghawa.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made mention of the purity of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in all aspects, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, your companion has not been astray, he's not astray, nor has he lost the way.
الله سبحانه وتعالى قد زكاه في كله فقال.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made mention of the purity of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in every aspect. So Allah says,
وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ.
Indeed, you are upon the highest level of character and conduct.
وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ.
Indeed, you are upon the highest level of character and conduct.
إِذَا أَرَدْتَ أَن تَسْأَلَ عَنْ أَخْلَاقِ الرَّجُلِ.
If you want to ask about the character of a person,
فَاسْأَلْ أَهْلَهُ فَإِنَّهُمْ أَدْرَى النَّاسِ بِهِ.
You need to ask the family members who live with that person, because they know him or her better than anyone else.
مِنْ أَجْلِ ذَلِكَ ذَهَبَ الصَّحَابَةُ إِلَى أُمِّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَائِشَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهَا.
And because of this, the Sahaba or the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went to أم المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله عنها.
فَقَالُوا لَهَا يَا عَائِشَة.
They asked her, O Aisha,
كيف أخلاقه صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
How is the character and conduct of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
فأجابت فقالت.
So she answered by saying,
كان خلقه القرآن.
His character was the Quran. He embodied the entire Quran in his character and conduct.
كان عليه الصلاة والسلام يطبق آيات القرآن في مشيه وفي تعامله وفي تجارته وفي ضحكه وفي أموره كلها صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to follow, and he used to be exactly what the Quran has taught in terms of his speech and his laughter and all aspects of his character.
من أجل ذلك قال الله.
And for this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا.
Indeed, for you in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a beautiful example to follow for those who are looking forward to the hereafter and those who remember Allah often.
والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تعامله أفضل تعامل وأخلاقه أجمل الأخلاق.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم's dealings with people and his character was definitely the best.